TikTok, the social media platform that made line dancing cool again, is between a rock and a hard place right now. The rock is the Trump administration, and the hard place is security concerns due to their Chinese-owned parent company, ByteDance. Now, because of the funky situation TikTok has found itself in, lots of their main creators are jumping ship to a new and very similar platform, Triller. And Facebook is paying some influencers to switch to their almost ready, not quite released platform, Reels. So I'm going to do a quick review of the TikTok saga and compare Triller to TikTok to Reels so you can make sure those funky edits and snazzy dance moves will be seen if TikTok bites the dust. And this is why I'm not TikTok famous. If you haven't yet, don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and of course, turn on those notifications. I come out with new videos every Wednesday and Friday, and I'd love for you to join along. So TikTok, you've either heard of it or you use it. It's a name that has come a really long way over the last few years. And now at its peak, the Trump administration, along with some senators and representatives from all sides of the political aisle, are worried about security concerns because of its parent company, who is based in China. Worried that the Chinese government will have unfettered access to Americans' private information, Trump has given TikTok until September to either sell or make some serious changes to their privacy policy. If that doesn't happen, TikTok risks getting banned, setting loose 100 million daily American TikTok users. So where will we all go? Well, there's a few options, but Triller is the biggest competitor at the moment, with Reels, owned by Facebook, making a splash, and it hasn't even been released yet. So how does it stack up against TikTok? And are either of them really safe to use? Well, let me show you. First, let's take a look at privacy concerns and parent companies, which is the big reason TikTok might go bye-bye. TikTok's parent company is called ByteDance, which is based in China. ByteDance acquired a company called Musical.ly a few years ago and updated it to create TikTok and has since grown it to one of the biggest social media platforms in the world. Now, ByteDance is also the parent company to many other social media platforms that are used in China and around other Asian countries. Now, ByteDance's TikTok servers are hosted in the United States and Singapore and not China. But there are still some concerns that China would have full control over the data, even though TikTok's CEO, former Disney exec Kevin Mayer, says the Chinese government has not asked for user info and that if they did, TikTok would not supply it. Now let's take a look at Triller. Triller is owned by Proxima Media, an entertainment investment company that has financed and produced hundreds of feature films and TV shows. Now I can't find where Triller's servers are hosted, but because it's an American-owned company, I assume the servers are based in the US and therefore aren't as easily accessible by the Chinese government, but you know what they say about assuming. So that is parent companies. Now it's time to talk privacy concerns, which is truly the biggest issue at hand here. Now, I didn't read all of TikTok's privacy policy, but I'm linking it in the description if you want more information. But I am breaking down the bigger points of it. First, we're going over information that you choose to provide, AKA this is the info you volunteer to give up to TikTok when you sign up for an account, just signing up for one. TikTok will have your age, your username, your password, and other registration info, including social media account information if you log in through Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. TikTok will also have your payment info and contact info if you choose to sync your address book to your account, just to name a few. Now, once you're on the platform, TikTok will automatically collect more information like usage info. So your created content, how often you're on TikTok, and what you like and dislike. TikTok will also get your device information like your IP address, the type of phone or device you're using, your mobile carrier, keystroke patterns and rhythms, and more. They'll also get your location data, that's self-explanatory. TikTok will also have access to your messages, so any messages you send or receive on the platform. TikTok also has access to metadata, aka data that helps decipher other types of data, like when you upload content, keywords and videos you like, videos you're watching, captions you're writing, etc. And they also track with cookies. Basically, they watch where you go before and after you leave TikTok and how you're interacting with the app. The scary part is that this cookie information is given to third-party advertisers who can use it to target specific ads to you. Now, TikTok doesn't regulate how these third parties use that info. Now, you can disable cookies manually on your phone if you don't want that to happen. And lastly, technically, TikTok says they don't sell this information to third parties. However, they do have business partners and service providers they work with. And TikTok says, quote, "We are not responsible for the privacy practices of these service providers and business partners. And the information practices of these service providers and business partners are not covered by this privacy policy." So, if this sounds uncomfortable to you, I highly, highly recommend disabling cookies on your phone. Now, I can talk a lot more about this, but really I'm getting off track. I'm starting to realize I might need to make a whole new video on the subject of privacy and cookies and how to deal with all that. But for now, you can Google how to turn off cookies on my insert phone here. Whew. So, this might be concerning and a lot to take in. However, TikTok's privacy policy is pretty run-of-the-mill and standard for most social media platforms, and quite honestly, Triller's looks very similar. Now, basically, the only information Triller doesn't collect is your personal health history, but everything else is on the table, including your social security number, browser history, advertising interactions, education records, biometric info like fingerprints, face prints, and voice prints, your keystroke info, your gait, aka how you walk, and other health patterns, plus bank and credit card info, and more. So what does Triller do with this info? Well, they don't sell it, but they work with business partners who use it, and they share it with third-party companies who might use it for advertising purposes or other services that aren't mentioned. Basically, both platforms have pretty liberal privacy policies, if we can even call them that, because honestly, nothing about you is private anymore. And if you want to see what information both platforms have collected on you, you can go to your profile and check out the security and privacy section and request a copy of your data, and they will give it to you in about 30 days or less. So these privacy policies just in general concern me, but the major concern here for the Trump administration and other policymakers is TikTok's connection with the Chinese government. They don't want our info getting into the hands of the Chinese government, which is why a sale or a complete ban of the app are both on the table. But even if China doesn't have this info, dozens, if not hundreds of companies across the country do, and you better believe they're using it. Now, when we're talking TikTok, TikTok is huge, like really huge. It has over 2 billion worldwide users with nearly 200 million US downloads. Triller is big, but not huge. It is gaining traction daily, but has a long way to go before it can really compete with TikTok. It has 250 million worldwide users and 23 million US downloads. The big thing with Triller, though, is that Triller is buying and hiring really popular influencers from TikTok to ditch that platform and move to Triller. Some of them are becoming even executives high up in this company to try and gain traction with other US users who might want to leave TikTok due to these privacy concerns. Now, when it comes to functionality of the apps, they're basically carbon copies of each other with a few differences. Now, TikTok has 2 feeds to scroll through, a feed for people you follow, and a feed that's curated by the TikTok algorithm, aka the For You section. Triller has 3 categories: a section for people you follow, a section for music or videos that are based around music, and a social section for videos that may have music but aren't based on music. So that's the top part of the app, and then there's the bottom section. Both apps give you 5 different tabs to switch between, including discovery, creation, notifications, and your personal profile. The only difference is the far left tab, which is home for TikTok and a music selection for Triller. Now, my prediction is that TikTok isn't going anywhere anytime soon, and that Triller and Reels, when it's released, won't ever catch up to TikTok's notoriety. But if you want more content, download them. They're basically the same, and you you won't really notice a difference. I mean, Triller just sued TikTok because their platforms are that similar. So that's really what you're looking at here. Now, the only thing to keep in mind is every social media account you sign up for, you're putting your personal info into the hands of more and more companies and potentially governments. Okay, after all of this, should we be worried about TikTok and their connection to China? Now, if we think China might have access to our info, then yes. But I think we should be just as worried about Triller, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter and other social media platforms because they all have similar privacy practices. So what do you think about Trump looking to ban TikTok or potentially the sale to Microsoft? Personally, I think he feels a little angry that a bunch of tweens outsmarted one of his rallies and he's looking for payback. But tell me what you think. I'm Sherry Riggs with Whistle Out TV.